am Francis Mascarenhas. Formerly I was in Bombay, but now I'm staying at One World. My son is there, he's 36 years old. I tried my level best, I prayed, I went, I took him everywhere possible. Even I brought him here for 2 retreats. The same old story, back to the pavilion, same. Now for the last 1 month, more than that, he has left the house and he has gone. We don't know. We try to contact everybody, but we don't know exactly where he's gone. So now I came to pray for my son down here. So when I came down inside the Divine Call Center, I left everything behind. I said, my God, Lord Jesus is here. I will get an answer from here. Because in confession, I confessed my sin, and for all the wrongs which I had done, I heard the word of God, confession, inner healing, I feel a filling of the Holy Spirit. Now, I know my God very well. This place here is God's prudence, and this place is on heaven and earth. And I would thank all the priests down here who are working with their zeal and enthusiasm to pray for everyone's need. And what I want to say, I thought, why should I pray? Because I was always praying. And for the last 2 years, I have not been to this place. Otherwise, I was a regular coming down here. So now I made up my mind, so whatever it's possible, I'll pray to my Almighty God, and He'll help me out. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. And love you, Jesus.
My name is Pradeep D'Souza. I'm from Karkala. 3 months back, I went to Dubai to look for a job. I have done my MBA in HR in Bangalore and I've worked over there for 2 years. I went over there. While going to Dubai, I had my manager who was working in Dubai as HR director for one of the hotels. He gave me some references, like big references of directors, general managers, and everyone. When I went there, my cousins, they are really into prayers and all. They go to Divine Mercy every Friday. And they said, you have come at the right time. Pray Divine Mercy daily night, midnight at 3 o'clock. You'll get his blessings. Even they used to woke up, pray with me, Divine Mercy. And I got a call from one of the company on the day of the Feast of Divine Mercy. I went to an interview, I got selected, but the salary they offered was low. In my mind, what thought came, here they're giving me low salary, so why not I'll go to other people whom my manager has referred. So I went there. I spoke to each of them, everyone rejected. I also left this job. So everywhere I couldn't find any job over there for 1 month, till April I didn't find. Then I was suffering from inside. I asked God, why did you create me? Why did you get me into this suffering? You should have killed me. Many things I spoke ill about him. What was the main reason I couldn't get? Then again, after some days, I don't know what went to my mind. I went back through this history, like 1 month, what wrong I did in over there. Then I thought, I didn't believe in God, God's blessings. I believe in human blessings. So I lost that job. God will never give me what I cannot handle. He gave me a good job, but because of other things, I left. Then next day, I went out with my cousin. He took me to his company. There I met one person. He said, go to NMC, they will help you, and they will have recruitment. So I went there next day, early morning. There they said, wait, we'll see. I went to a shopping mall. When I was shopping, I saw a board of a hospital. I asked them in that mall, where's this hospital? They said, behind. I went there. They said, we don't have a recruitment division here. It is in some other place, Ajman, that was like 2 hours journey from there. So I went, I didn't have any work, I went over there. There, I don't know what happened, suddenly 3 people came, first one, second one, they took my interview. And they said, okay, you have done very good, because I was not prepared actually. I just went to give the CV, but they gave me this, they took my interview and they said it was very good. I went home, they said they'll call me for the next round. I went home, I was very happy, thanking God. Then I started again doing Divine Mercy, but it was not that punctual what I did before. So I used to break in between. Then again I went, they didn't call me for 1 or 2 weeks. I went back again, I asked them, they said the company had put the position on hold. So I was roaming around, I still didn't get a job. Coming to India, like I came on 15th. 13th I went again over there. They said that position is still on hold. There's one more position, we'll speak to the manager. They called me next day for an interview. I went in interview, the interview was cleared. They said, we'll call you, anything it is there, we'll call you to India number. They took all my certificates and I was happy. I came down but could not, didn't get any call from there. Even when I called them, they said the manager has not given anything. No response from his side. So I didn't want to come here. My mother's, I wanted to go to Bombay. Tabor, yeah. But my mother said, don't go there, go here. I said, I'll not go. Then I was doing other works and all. Again, my mom said, you have some time, go over there. Okay, so for that reason, I came here. When I came here, the first day, the retreat was okay. I went to my room, I opened one Bible, I opened the Bible, and when I was reading, there came a word like, it was, how I can explain, I don't know. But not Catholics, other people will come and take your sons for their daughter in Exodus. So that I read, and I happened to, I'm in love with the Hindu girl. So next day when I came here morning, I couldn't hear any retreat. Whole day it was going again. I have seen, I have done this, I have done wrong. Everything was going on. Monday was over. Tuesday early morning I came, first retreat. I couldn't even sit over there. 1.5 hours I had trouble sitting here. Went to have breakfast, couldn't have breakfast. I don't know, I didn't know what to do. Went, I called her. I asked you to convert to Christian, will you be? Yes, I am ready, she said. But even that also didn't convince me. Then I left everything. I was roaming around in the room. Then she called me, go to church, you'll have peace. She knows whenever I have trouble, I go to church and I have peace. So went in front of the sacrament. There I said to Lord, Lord, I don't know the girl which I love. We will be together happily or not. But you know, if we are together, if we will be happy together, come between us and unite us. If not, you can take away from him. I'll not say anything. From that moment, I got peace. Then later, I came to hear about the prayers, how prayers should be done, how prayer is important, and about the Eucharistic celebration. That moment, I realized what mistake I did in Dubai. Dubai, when I was praying Divine Mercy prayer, I used to tell Lord, I used to pray, then I used to tell Lord, Lord, I'm praying it now, but don't expect me to continue this further. I may not do. So that thing I used to say. Yeah, seriously, it was like that for me. When I heard all these things over here, then I realized why prayer is important. And it was Him, God, who brought me here to know the importance. He has done many miracles in my life. I don't say no. He was there always with me. And He has shown miracles I have seen, and I praise Him. But that one mistake has caused, like, coming back. I also realized the job which were there, I got, two jobs are there, still there, it is kept pending, not given anyone, it has kept pending. But now here, I am not expecting that job to come, but I am happy that I came here. I realized what the importance of prayer, what the importance of Eucharist and everything.
My name Anita, I am from Womanjur. I am also a religious. From 2 months, a month of May, I had to come back home. From the childhood, I have never experienced a lot of peace in the family. I am coming from a very poor family. We are four children in the family, and I lost my father 12 years ago. He got a cancer and we lost him. I have a mother who is always sick. She has back problems and she does work, but every now and then she falls sick. And an elder sister with lot of difficulty, she got married, but after a year she had to break up her marriage because her husband was in relationship with one more woman. And I have a one more sister who was also religious, but she had to come back because of some reason. And I have a brother who is drinking and smoking. He doesn't take responsibility of the family. And I am the youngest, and I thought at least God will never do to me like that, but he has also done the same thing. Like, I was always disappointed. I used to pray. I had a lot of trust in him. But when it happened to me recently, I could not take up. In front of people, I have to show that, like, I have a lot of hope. I have a lot of trust in him. But within me, I am fully broken. I don't have that much of trust as I was having before. Before I could come here, I was, like, I didn't have peace. But in front of my mother, I could not show that pain. So I used to show as if I am very happy. And when I came here, first 2 days, I did not feel that I should pray. What is the use of praying? Because before this incident could take place, I had gone for retreat in Tabor Ashram. And I prayed, I cried. But this incident took place, so I thought, this time I am praying, what is the use of praying? Because God doesn't listen to my prayers. So 2 days, and I was sick also, I could not pray. So then, now after third day of retreat, I felt a peace within me, and I feel that there is a hope. And I have decided to, I had a dream that I want to remain as a religious. So God has given me one more chance that I am about to join one more religious congregation, maybe next month. So I asked Jesus that whatever decision I have taken, that he should be with me. So I feel that he is assuring me that he'll be there with me. And now I feel that I am peaceful and he is there with me. Thank you, Jesus.